Hello everyone, this is future PhD Dr. E speaking, and this is another episode of Putting the U Back in Grad School. Today's episode is going to be a bit a little different. In the previous three episodes, I was in the studio, and this episode, I'm on campus because we're going to talk about life as a University of Michigan grad student. So let's get into it. So for this episode, we're going to break it up into three. The first part is going to be life as a beginning graduate student, or life in your first 2 years of your master's or PhD program. Then for part two is going to be life as an intermediate grad student. And finally is going to be life as an advanced grad student. First 2 years for master's and PhD students are pretty similar, and you're probably going to do a lot of classwork. And with that in mind, I'm just going to show you a little tour of North Campus. Right now, I'm in the EECS building. EECS is an acronym for EECS, which is the Combined Building for Electrical Engineering and Computer Science. And it has three levels. And I kind of like this building because it's very new. One thing I like about University of Michigan is all buildings are open 24/7. So you have a lot of choice when to study. So I personally like to mix it up. And I'm going to show you an example of one of the rooms in the EECS building. This is a room in the EECS building, and I used to study here a lot, especially for exams. One of the reasons why I like this building is you see all this space. You can just expand. You can put your laptop, you can put your backpack, you can have all your study notes all in one place. It's fairly quiet, and it's kind of a hidden gem because a lot of people, at least when I was studying, weren't here. We also have like a bunch of outlets, like you can see outlet right here, and there's a bunch of boards so you can practice and you can get more familiar with the material. Right now I'm in the Degrasse building, and I like the Degrasse building because it's kind of all in one shop. You have Mujo, which is basically getting your coffee and your snacks. You of course have a library. And you also have some study rooms you can go to. You also have access to dual screen computer. But even when you're studying, you probably want some time to maybe chill or maybe have time to express yourself. And Degrasse has all of that. I'm currently walking to the first floor where we have an underground library if you really want to be quiet and you really want to focus. And there's also a game room. Unfortunately, the game room is closed on weekends. I didn't know that. But here is a glimpse of what the game room is about. They have Red Dead Redemption. They have any game from like probably the 1980s to present. They have an old Dragon Lair game, which I think is a board game, for Metal Gear as well. They also have more than video games. They have board games, they have tabletop games, they have pretty much anything you want. And I think it's a pretty fun room. I've been here a few times. So yeah, if you ever come to Michigan, come between Monday and Friday and enjoy it out yourself. This is still a scooter set, but I wanted to show the other cool services and features Degrasse offers. So this is a visualization room. You can do a lot of cool 3D things. The student right here is using the Oculus Rift for VR. And you don't have to be a major to work with this. If you have interest, you can definitely get training. You can go on this yourself. And this is the fabrication studio. These machines are 3D printers, and here's an example of all the various things you can print. All you need is be a student, and basically you just have to have your design and the materials, and they basically let you print for free.
So that was a fun little distraction, and I only included it because I wanted to give you prospective students a glimpse on what you can do when you're not studying for classes all the time. And with that, we're going to go to the differences in class size between undergrad and grad school. Fair warning, this next series of footage is a bit old, as in like last Friday, this is Sunday, and I don't want to re-record it because the rooms are currently being booked on Sunday. So let's get into the differences.
So one thing you should know about grad school is class sizes are significantly smaller. For example, I'm going to show you into a lecture hall. So in this lecture hall, you can see it has space for around 500 to 600 students. And now I'm about to show you a graduate school size class. This is the auditorium for classes for graduate students for chemical engineering at University of Michigan. As you can see, there is significantly less seats and there's a significantly smaller room. And that's primarily because in graduate school, there are far less students. So you can practice your skill sets more deeply than broadly.
So in your second year as a PhD and definitely your third year, you're going to be focused more on the research component of your PhD because you're done with classes. And right now I'm going to show you NCRC.
So this is NCRC. As you can see, it's pretty big. And this is building 28. So my left is building 32. And this is only a slight fraction of it. NCRC used to be the Pfizer building, and since then it has been converted to the various research labs at University of Michigan. There's chemical engineering, there's electrical engineering, there's biomedical engineering. There's a lot of engineering labs here. In addition, there are also a lot of dental labs, there's a lot of medical doctors at work here. So NCRC is a great place to do interdisciplinary research. So one of the biggest components of being a PhD student specifically is research. And right now this is my lab. This is the Thurber lab. And what we do is a lot of biomedical research. And it's pretty empty right now because it's pretty early. It's around 9:30-ish. And yeah, I'm just going to give you a little tour of the labs.
And over here is my lab bench. Everyone's gone because it's been Sunday except for one person.
Hi.
This is how long he's part of my lab. One thing you should think about when choosing a lab is the facilities. The Thurber lab is pretty new, so we have all the facilities we need to do good research. That's not to say you bad facilities can make or break your lab experience, but good facilities can definitely speed up your research. And I think this would be.
So this is the office here. And you want to make sure as a grad student, a PhD student specifically, you have an office all to yourself, because you definitely want a personal space where you can just think about things. Not all schools provide offices, but you definitely should want an office so you can definitely talk to your lab mates, have some personal time to think, also have some personal space just to relax, just because you're going to be spending a lot of time in the office, and you want to make sure that you're comfortable. As I mentioned in my previous videos, for getting a PhD, you usually contribute to the field, and one of the ways you do that is by presenting posters. Behind me is my lab poster. We're going about to flip it over. This is my lab's poster. We have three main research thrusts, which is drug distribution, peptide engineering, and diagnostic imaging agents. What I think a good poster should do is give you a very non-technical explanation of what you're doing and how it works. For example, I'm going to focus on orally available imaging agents because this is my project specifically. Basically, we want to use near-infrared light that is highly orally available, which means you can take it out of a pill, it can bind to a disease target, and you can also see it under light. And over here, you can see that in white light, this is a mouse with cancer. Under white light, you can see the tumor, but if you have near infrared fluorescence, you can see the tumor very well. And the whole point of this is we want to see how early we can detect the tumor. And now I'm going to give you a slideshow.
So in the last few years of your PhD experience, you are looking less into research and you're looking more into mentoring and going to the next steps. And for the mentoring aim, you're teaching undergraduates how to do research, and you're also mentoring first and possibly second year PhD students how to become more productive. In the next steps, you might be looking into academia as a postdoc, you might be looking in industry, and the possibilities are endless. As I mentioned in the earlier videos, getting a PhD opens a lot of doors, and with a PhD in hand or almost in hand, you're starting to look for opportunities you're interested in.
And that's the end of this week's episode. Next week's episode, we're going to talk about the cool things you can do in Ann Arbor and the surrounding areas. So this is Future PhD, Dr. E, signing out.